There you go.
Forever sing his praise.
Thank you. Apparently, everyone else was ready.
But I wasn't. Welcome. Mr. I am so sorry. I was listening nicely to a prelude and going, something's very quiet. You know, that happens sometimes. Again, I welcome you. My name is Dr. Frank Dunbar, the Director of Congregational Care here at the United Health District, and it's great to see you. I'm looking at a couple windows, which is kind of a nice, exciting experience. The speakers are on. You can see those, and somebody is waving at me.
Your mic is not on. Your mic is not on.
Just turn it on.
Better now? I get to start all over again as well. Ron's happy about it. My apologies for the second time in a row. I'm not doing so well this morning. Again, my name is Dr. Frank Dunbar. I'm the Director of Congregational Care here at Newburgh United Methodist Church, and I really want to welcome you. Now that you're actually in the spot that you need to be, and I'm in the spot that I need to be with the microphone turned on to our worship, the service this morning, if you are here in the sanctuary or if you are at home watching online. Thankfully, if you're online, it's a 30-second delay, so all you just heard that was chaos, they get 30 seconds afterwards. You know, it's a crazy experience. Want to let you know that we have a wonderful worship service for you this morning. We're excited about that. If you have the QR code in front of you on the pews, if you want to pull down the worship for today and the way that the bulletin looks, you can do it that way. If you're at home, you can go on the website under Sunday mornings. You'll see a tab, and there's a bulletin tab there as well, and you can go ahead and pull that down for yourself as well. We ask you to fill out the Connect card if you can, so we know that you are here. We're trying to track who is able to get to worship. It's kind of important for us in a variety of ways, and it's just meaningful for us to know that you are here. Also, you can leave Connect card information for prayers and that kind of thing on the Connect card, so it's certainly a way of making sure we are connected as we go forward. So with that, let me go ahead and leave the rest of the announcements to the video upcoming.
Hey Newburgh, it's Kyle Berry, your Director of Music and Worship Arts, and here's what you need to know for this week. First off, we're looking for some people to join our tech team during the worship services. If you can press a button, then you can learn how to be one of our tech team members. If you're interested, you can contact me or check out the link on our webpage, newburghumc.org/events. Next up, we have an adult missions trip opportunity coming up soon to God's Cooperative Parish. If you're interested, you can register online on our website or contact Reverend Rodney Gasway. Finally, mark your calendars for September 12th, when we're going to have a special service and our church picnic. We hope to see you there. All of these and more can be found at our website, newburghumc.org/events. Now, let's come together in one spirit to praise and glorify our great God.
Please rise for our opening hymn.
Thank you.
praise and glorify our God, who gives his grace in Christ. In him our sins are washed away, redeemed through sacrifice. In him God has made known to us the mystery of his will, that Christ should be
Like she said, you may be seated. That was awesome. As we begin our time of prayer this morning, I want to remind you that we have on our website prayers that are ongoing all the time for folks in the congregation. You can look those up in the newsletter. You'll see those at the bottom, and you can just take a look at the folks we're praying for all the time. With that in mind, we have some special prayers for this morning that we are aware of. Skylar Schofield is back home from her hospital stay due to a severe asthma attack. Please offer healing prayers for her as she gains her strength back. Betty Wilson, many of you may know Betty, had a successful pacemaker operation on Thursday. She is now back at Ashford Court and about as chipper and as hopeful after her surgery as I have ever seen her. If you know Betty at all, she had severe heart issues, just they couldn't get a handle on it, and they believe the pacemaker is going to help, and she is obviously, it's nice to see her smiling literally through the phone after the surgery. Karen Golden has requested continued prayers as she continues with the new treatments on her plan on her knee. She's had three treatments now. Things are going well, but continued prayers for Karen. Also for Karen's daughter, Angela, who is pregnant but in a high-risk pregnancy, and just continued long-term prayers for her as she approaches her due date in September. Vicki Rowe has requested continued healing prayers for her leg, which, as you know, she broke. And Linda Plostito has requested continued prayers for her grandson, Joshua, and his wife, Catherine, for a safe full-term delivery of their child as well. And Jerry Noel has let us know that his son, Jeff, still struggling with intestinal issues, and prayers for him and for the family. Also, we got word this morning, Kathy Stone, who you may know, the Stones were members here for a while, but no longer members here, but Kathy Stone, first wife of Craig Stone, beloved mother of Nick and Edward Stone, passed away suddenly without warning 2 weeks ago. We did get word of that this morning, and so prayers for their family as well. If you would take all of these that we have mentioned, combine them with the thoughts that are on your hearts, both here in the sanctuary and at home, and join me in a word of prayer. Gracious and loving God, who cares for all of us in ways far beyond our understanding, we come together today to worship you and pray for the people we love, to pray for our church, and pray for our world. As we pray for the folks whom we have named this morning, please acknowledge not just those, but the silent prayer still on our hearts, or the prayers of those participating in worship from home. We have learned, Lord, to pray in every setting and at every time needed, and we trust in your infinite wisdom. And so we pray for our family and our friends. We pray for those in stress. We pray for those with treatment plans ongoing, those with long-term illnesses, and those with short-term challenges of health or job or personal relationships of any kind. We pray especially this week for those where a family member or friend has passed away. We ask for peace and comfort for families with this kind of loss. Lord, we are not just in our own sanctuary or in our own city. We are also praying for our world and our region this week. This week, there were significant storms in our region, and people have lost power. Some still don't even have power. Even coming to church this morning, I saw crews coming from Kansas to assist us. Lord, we pray for those who have lost power, those who have had damage in their homes. And we pray for those crews that are obviously exhausted trying to repair everything at this point. Keep them on point. We love the people who come to help us. And may we return the favor at some point in their history. We also pray, though, for those in the healthcare professions as they battle yet again another wave of COVID. This virus that has just plagued us constantly. Lord, we ask for your patience as we try to seek people to get treatment, seek people to get inoculations and the vaccines that are needed. And for those that can't, for whatever reason, we ask your special comfort for them, and especially for those that have children under 12 who are still waiting for the opportunity. Lord, we pray also for Haiti, another damaging week for Haiti, and maybe one even upcoming with a hurricane coming, but this time it's another earthquake in a country that needs no more destruction. Lord, we have missioned there, we have been there, we have helped the people there. Now we ask for your guidance as rescue crews and rebuilding crews are needed once again. Lord, we pray for the country of Afghanistan, for our evacuation forces there, and for the Afghan people who remain after the Taliban will most clearly take over very shortly. Lord, it's a challenging time in that country. We ask for prayers for all those evacuating and all those who remain, as we've said. But just a special moment of silence in thinking of all the energy we've put into that country in the 20 years we have been there. Lord, we pray for shut-ins. We pray for those of limited mobility and despair and depression that sometimes is caused by isolation. We pray for those folks that just can't be here. May we be the church that reaches out to them. And lastly, Lord, we pray for those who are continuing cancer treatment, be it successful or challenging. We know that this is a special moment for many folks and folks that we know. So, Lord, we pray for the people we have named, the situations we have mentioned, and importantly, the people, conditions, and circumstances that remain on our heart this day as we collectively pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Closing our time of prayer and opening our time of offering is what we are doing now. And just want you to be aware again of the variety of ways that you can give to the church. Please partake in that as we're still in a financial situation that requires especially general fund assistance. So as we look at new windows in our church with the sticker still on them, letting us know that they are new, that's a building fund expense. And so and building fund has been doing fairly well. But if you can assist in the general fund, we'd certainly appreciate it at this point in time. There are a variety of ways to give. They're all on the screen in front of you or on your screen at home. And we would ask for your prayers at this point in time and ask for your opportunity to give. And so with that, our time of offering. Thank you. Would you join me in a word of prayer? Loving Lord, as we give today, we give knowing that you provide the places for us to serve. We ask your blessing on all the people who are here, those that have given in whatever way they've given. And may we use the gifts that have been given to the church in the ways that you see fit to build your kingdom here on earth. And it is in Jesus' name all of God's people said together, Amen.
Giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of God for all God's people. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everyone. For anyone who doesn't know me, I'm sorry, no. I'm Ron Blaisdell. I'm one of your lay speakers here. And every once in a while in summertime, I get to fill in. So it's always fun. I, by the way, have called an audible, and I have changed the name of the sermon. And I think you'll figure out the title as this goes. That's what happens when you don't preach all the time. You have a habit of rewriting your sermon 50 or 60 times. So it is what it is. I admitted to you all last time that I struggle with Paul. So I kind of forced myself to do that again. I'm a glutton for punishment. I could have cheated and gone with John this week because we had a real beautiful John passage. But I decided, no, I'm going to stick with Ephesians because it kind of fits something that I remember from years back. And I'll talk about that in a minute. You know, today we don't have, unfortunately, as many young children and babies as we normally had in our congregation, these pandemic congregations of today. Sometimes they were a little louder than their parents wished they were, but it was the sound of life. It was the sound of living. It was the sound of living out loud. And I miss it dearly. I really do. We hear it from the kids at home, whether they cry out to us, Mom, Dad, Grandma, Grandpa, Papa, look at me, listen to me, play with me. And they grab a hold of our legs, or if you're my granddaughter, you sit on my foot, which is really bad for a guy with one bad hip. But hey, I try anyway. And what they're doing is they're trying to get our attention. They're trying to live out loud. Teens do it. They have wild clothes and wild makeup, listen to really loud music, squeal a few car tires. I listened to lots of loud music and squealed a lot of car tires in my day. I was living out loud too. Back in Maryland, in the Baltimore-Washington Conference, I was serving as a senior high youth counselor. I actually did that for about 13 years. But we had a conference out there one time out at our camp on the Delaware Shore, and it was entitled Living Out Loud. That was the theme for the youth conference there. And all my senior high youth and I went, and we had a grand old time. And the youth ran the conference, which I really loved, to tell you truthfully. And they worshiped. They grew together. They sang. They praised. They got a little crazy, but they had a lot of fun. And they, too, were living out loud. Living out loud, by the way, doesn't necessarily mean being noisy and raucous and, you know, it can be expressed in quietness and in peace and living a good life. But what the Apostle Paul calls us to do in today's lesson, he says, be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Speak to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual ways. Sing and make music with your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is how we can live out loud and as examples for all people to see. The words from Paul fall in the middle of a really large section on living a Christian life and our relationships. That's what Ephesians is really all about. We who are dead in our sins and non-belief have been made alive with Christ. By grace, we have been saved. A good question then is, how does God, who saved me, want me to live? And this is what Paul tries to answer to us in this particular sermon. It was six whole verses, by the way, and he gives us five imperatives. That's Paul. And his whole idea is that he wants us to be grateful for the Lord's love and for salvation. And he wants us to live out loud as Christians in this world. He calls us to be careful, to be wise, to use our time, to be filled with the Holy Spirit, and give thanks. And God certainly doesn't leave us in the dark as to how he wants us to live as his children. In verse 15, I can't hardly talk, Paul writes, "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise." So Paul urges us to live as children of light and find what it is that pleases the Lord, and to realize that by the miracle of God's grace, we are spiritually alive. Our Savior signs on us with his love and forgiveness, and God has placed the precious gift of salvation in our hearts and in our hands. We could toss it all away and just discard it as though it was worthless. And you say to yourself, who would do such a thing? Well, we would, which is why Paul reminds us, hey, be careful. Being wise means that we can discern between what is proper and what is not. It means, too, that we can recognize the challenges we face as Christians. Therefore, we step carefully, remembering the darkness is ever on the prowl. We guard and protect the precious gift of God's grace that we have been given. Through his word and empowered and guided by his Holy Spirit, we embrace the grace of God as another priceless gift. Paul continues on in verse 16, and he says, make the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. Obviously, you don't have to be the best detective in the world to figure out that days are evil. We watch the local news, we read the paper, we see what's going on. We hear the anguish of the people in Haiti. We see what's happening in Iraq. We know that evil is abounding. Dark violence, pale apathy, red lust, green greed have always been black with sin. But the onward expression of evil in the name of good is profoundly different. Since this is so, Paul encourages us who bear the name of Jesus to make the most of the time that we have been given and to make good use of the opportunity that it affords. What are those opportunities? First, Paul wants us to seize every opportunity to be strengthened and built up by a means of grace, to be strengthened by God's word. He's leading us to overcome evil with good. Paul encourages us in verse 17, therefore do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Paul gets redundant, and he says for emphasis, don't be foolish, and understand what the Lord's will is, because this is where true wisdom is found. The Lord doesn't want his people to be ostriches and stick their heads in the sand. He wants us to be people with our heads in the Bible. He wants us to understand that that is the only way we understand our Lord and what he wants from us. For the word is what we learn from, and it's the first item on God's will list, is for sinners to be with him in heaven. And for this reason, Jesus came from heaven to earth and allowed himself to undergo crucifixion as our sinless substitute. Eternal blessings are what the Lord wants for us. And what does he want from us? He wants our hearts, trusting in our Savior and responding to his grace, living out loud in grateful service. Martin Luther lived out loud. And as a Christian, he went against the Catholic Church. First, he rebelled against the sale of indulgences, which was a way of getting out of sin. And then through study, he started understanding that our salvation is totally dependent on the sacrifice of Jesus and through our faith in him. It was Luther who went against the tide of the world. His voice stood out from the crowd. And what about us? How is wisdom of God and grateful service to Him lived out? As children, we live out when we listen to Him and learn from our parents and their patience and instruction. As teenagers, we learn to live out loud when we go against the sinful tide of the world. The world can hear you loud and clear when you're bold enough not to follow the crowd when it heads off in the wrong direction. You live out loud when you say, I'm not going to do that. As adults, we continue to live out loud as Christians in the world when we bring our children to be baptized. We lead them to the church. We guide them, love them, and set a good example for them. Even more important to us is the grace of God in our lives. All too often we fail to live out and live out loud in the world. Our hearts are not always in the right place. We are not obedient as children. Sometimes we do follow the crowd when it goes in the wrong direction. We don't lead or guide our children as we ought. We need God's grace. And we find it in Jesus Christ, who lived and died out loud for the world to see. We hear His voice that speaks forgiveness and life, and now our lives are not our own, but they are His. Our Lord has called us together to be His church. We gather and live out loud, filled by the Spirit. We join together, even if it's muffled under face masks at the moment, praising the Lord and singing in music with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with all our hearts. Through His Spirit, we can always be giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul is calling us to a life of thanksgiving, not just one Thanksgiving day. He is calling for a nonstop thanksgiving, not only at times of success and happy events, but for everything. We have a lot of blessings to be thankful for and a lot to be out loud about. We have been showered with spiritual gifts poured on us daily: forgiveness, peace, joy, love, hope, and everyday realities in and through Jesus. Because Jesus was crucified for us, we can claim God as our loving and caring Father. We know that He will work out everything, even life's little disasters and distresses. Thus, we are blessed with constantly grateful spirit, through whom we can live out loud and proclaim the name of Jesus. In His holy name we pray. Amen.
Please join us in our closing hymn. Lost.
be our gracious and holy Father. Fill you with His Spirit and with love and with wisdom. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Feet are firm, held by light of heaven he reigns, seated in the highest place, surrounded by unending praise. Praise him for his mighty deeds, awesome in his majesty. Praise him now with trumpet sounds, lift your voice and dance around. Everything that has breath, praise the Lord. Everything that's in us, praise him. Everything that has breath, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord with instruments, praise him for his excellence. Look at what he's done for us, bore our sins away.